In the late 2000s, NASCAR's future looked both bright and uncertain at the same time. While a plethora of talent was in the lower divisions, plenty of drivers' careers were halted or even ended by the 2008 recession. Even then, the 2008 ARCA series had plenty of talented drivers on track. Some have gone on to become Cup Series champions. Others have become Cup Series winners. Others have become well-respected veterans. Others have gone on to have great careers in other forms of motorsports. Throughout all of this great talent, there's one driver whose career was tragically cut short. A driver with all the talent on the track and a great attitude off of it. This is the story of Matt Hawkins. Matt was born in Canton, Georgia in 1988. As he grew older, he developed his love for racing. Like many racers, he started off in karts. In 2000, Matt would win two classes in the World Karting Championship. He would stay behind the wheel of a kart until 2003, where he would take part in Legends races at the Atlanta Motor Speedway Thunder Ring. This would only further Matt's love for racing. The next year in 2004, Matt would make the jump to super late models. He would even race in the 2004 Snowball Derby at just 16 years of age. While he had success, like most ventures into uncharted territory, he didn't end up in victory lane right away. 2005 would be a huge step up for Matt in terms of results. He would win the Southern All-Star Series Championship in his rookie year, and run well in many prestigious super late model races across the United States. In 2006, he would move to the Georgia Asphalt Series, where he would win twice. He would also, once again, race in the Snowball Derby. Not only that, he would win the Derby's annual support race, the Snowflake 100. Matt would continue to work his way up the stock car ranks in 2007, this time moving to the Hooters Pro Cup Series. In his first start at USA International Speedway, he would beat 16-year-old and eventual Daytona 500 winner, Trevor Bayne. While the season started off strong, his season would be hampered by inconsistency. When he stayed out of trouble, or if the car held together, he was almost a shoe-in for finishing in the top five. He even notched a second win at South Georgia Motorsports Park late in the season. With his Pro Cup season having its highs and lows, Matt would head to Five Flag Speedway to compete in the 2007 Snowball Derby. He started on the outside pole, with Cale Gayle on the inside. By the end of the first lap, Matt had already taken the lead, and would end up holding the lead more often than not during the event. On lap 215, Matt would lose the lead to Augie Grill, one of the better super late model racers in the country. Although Augie was, and still is, one of the more experienced super late model drivers, he had a hell of a task trying to hold off the 19-year-old. But once the checkered flag flew, Grill was the first across the line, with Hawkins close behind in second. The following year in 2008, Matt would continue to run in Hooters Pro Cup, while also making the move up to ARCA. In his first start, he would make a trip up to Iowa for the running of the Prairie Meadows 250. On lap 246, he would make a pass around Matt Carter for the lead, and would never look back.
What a terrific job that team has done. Matt Hawkins, first ever ARCA Remax start. You can see there's a gap right there from first to second. This will be it. 7/8 of a mile, the final lap from Iowa. Matt Hawkins, the Canton, Georgia native, looking to win his first ever race in the ARCA Remax Series. Justin Allgaier trying to make it four wins to his career, but just not enough laps left in this race. The battle for third, Frank Kimmel's able to get by Matt Carter. Coming out of turn four, Matt Hawkins will see the checkered flag for the first time in his career, winning at Iowa.
After his win at Iowa Speedway, he would make his second ARCA start two races later at Rockingham. He would show speed here as well, leading 25 laps on his way to a fourth place finish. He would make three more ARCA starts in 2008, earning a top 10 at Kentucky, finishing sixth, and a top 5 at Kansas, finishing fourth. While Matt showed speed in his ARCA starts, his 2008 Hooters Pro Cup season was inconsistent to say the least, where he would only earn two top 5s, 5 top 10s, and lead just 4 laps. With the Hooters Pro Cup season behind him, Matt headed to the Snowball Derby once more. While Matt had found success at Five Flags Speedway before, he would fight an uphill battle from the start of the weekend. First, a head gasket made him miss a good chunk of Friday's practice. He would only end up turning 38 practice laps all weekend. Then he would qualify with a hurt engine. But by late Saturday, Matt's number 22 was back on track after an engine change. When it was time for the green flag to drop, Matt would be starting in the rear with the previous Derby winner, Augie Grill. Both drivers would charge their way to the front throughout the race, and once the checkered flag waved, it was Grill in second and Hawkins in fourth. After Brian Eichler failed post-race tech, Augie Grill would be given the win, with Matt moving up onto the podium in third. With Matt ending the 2008 season on a high note, there was plenty of promise for next year. He was already rumored to move up to the Nationwide Series as soon as 2009, and I wouldn't doubt a bit that the rumors were in fact true. He was loved by fans and teams for both his driving talent and his personality. It was often stated that he left the doors to his shop open to the public, willing to strike up a conversation with anyone who came in to visit. Unfortunately, the 2008 Snowball Derby would be Matt's final race. Sometime in early 2009, Matt was either given or purchased a 9mm handgun. On Valentine's Day, Matt invited friends over to see what his new pistol looked like. While he was showing it to his friends, Matt removed the clip holding the rounds. The gun would then go off, and the round struck Matt in the head. Police officers and EMTs would rush to the scene. One of the officers had been a part of Matt's pit crew. When efforts were made to resuscitate him, he was beyond saving. Matt Hawkins passed away shortly after arriving to the hospital at age 21. Many talented drivers have come and gone through the years. Some have made it to great heights. Others never got an opportunity despite showing promise. But for Matt, it wasn't a case of if he was going to get a big break, but when was it going to happen? Unfortunately, we will never know when that time was going to be. We will never know what heights Matt would have reached. The only thing that's for certain is that we're still left wondering what could have been. Thank you all for watching. I'm Jesse King, and I'll see y'all around.